let's talk about stratigraphic contacts. So contacts between stratigraphic units can be either conformable if there is no gap in time, or unconformable if there's a gap in time between the unit below and the unit above. And this is known as an unconformity. And this is a very important concept to understand. So if we look at conformable contact, meaning contacts where there is no gap in time, we can also distinguish two types of contacts. A contact can be either abrupt or it can be gradational. So here between the Pele scene and the E scene, you can see that we have a conformable contact. There's no time gap. This is a deep sea core, but the contact is very abrupt. We go from almost 100% limestone to almost 0% limestone in this deep sea core. So there's a very clear contact here. Whereas when we go in the Eocene, in the early Eocene, we see that we have a recovery of carbonate content in the deep sea, but that recovery is gradational. There's also no time gap, but the contact is harder to spot here because it is an interval of progressively more carbonate content in the core. So let's review the types of unconformity we can find in the geological record. And for this, we will use the stratigraphic record of the Grand Canyon. So the first unconformity is the nonconformity. What is a nonconformity? A nonconformity is when sedimentary rocks are in contact with basement rock. And so by definition, when that happens, there is a time gap, so we're dealing with a nonconformity. In the Grand Canyon, we can see a nonconformity between the Vishnu schist at the bottom and the Precambrian sedimentary succession above. The Vishnu schist is a metamorphic rock, and the sediments above are sediments, so we have a nonconformity. We can recognize nonconformity thanks to the principle of inclusion. On the left, you can see that we have granite, and the granite is present as inclusion into the sediment. That implies that the granite is older than the sediment, and thus we're looking at a nonconformity. On the right, you can see that we have inclusions of the sandstone within the granite. That implies that the sandstone is older than the granite, and in this case, the granite is effectively a plutonic rock, an intrusion. And so we're not looking at a nonconformity. Another type of unconformity that is common is the angular unconformity. Now, the angular unconformity is interesting because it represents a significant time gap. So to form an angular unconformity, you first need to deposit the sediments. So you start in the sea with deposition of the sediments. But then you need to uplift the sediment in a tectonic event and fold them. So that's the stage two of the formation of an angular unconformity. It's the tectonic stage. Then you need to erode those folded sediments to obtain a nice planar surface. And finally, you need to have sea level rise and deposit a new series of sediments on top of this with that angular unconformity. So you can see that in these four steps, each one of the steps requires time, and overall an angular unconformity represents a significant time gap. In the Grand Canyon, we can see a beautiful angular unconformity between the sediments that you see here at the bottoms that show a very clear angular relationship with the sediments at the top. And this represents effectively the Precambrian to Paleozoic succession. And this indicates clearly that there's been some tectonic events on the North American craton at the end of the Precambrian. Now, disconformity are different. Disconformity essentially represent small erosional unconformity. They're not angular, but they're nevertheless clear erosional surfaces between two sedimentary layers. And there is, of course, because it's an unconformity, a significant time gap. So here's an example of a disconformity that is close from the Grand Canyon in Arizona, and it's between the Dakota Formation, where the red arrow is pointing, and the Cowspreaks Formation. And you clearly see an erosional contact here, again indicated by the red arrow, and even what appears to be channelized system in the middle here. So clear evidence of erosion, clear evidence of a time gap. This is a disconformity. And then there's another final type of unconformity that is common, and that is called a paraconformity. Now, paraconformity are extremely difficult to spot because effectively they show no sign of erosion whatsoever. So if you look at a paraconformity, what you will see is effectively a succession that appears continuous, that appears conformable. But if you look at the evidence for the timing, so for instance, if you look biostratigraphy, if you use biostratigraphy, what you will find is a significant time gap between two layers of rock. So here we're looking at the Manitou Formation and on top the Chaffee group, and effectively 25 million years of rock equivalents are missing. So there is a huge time gap here, but it's barely noticeable.